Gary Burbank turned out to be a good friend. So when it came time for him to do his Crusade for Children double album, he came to Trax. Working with Gary on this project taught me a new respect for nervously pacing back and forth. It was immediately obvious that we could not pace together in the same room without some serious coordination. So he was assigned a specific pace area, and I had my area. And usually the only time we both paced was during a listen back of a newly recorded segment. All in all, it was one of the most fun projects we ever did. Also, one of the most challenging. From 1980, here's Gary Burbank and his double Crusade album.
In the beginning, God created life. And God said, "It is good." But then God needed a punchline. So he created William Stansberry. God then turned to his followers and apologized. Well, if God is big enough to apologize, then Mayor Billy could do the same. And then there was a soul-cleansing news conference in front of the media Philistines and Philistines. They had once been smitten by the jawbone of an ass. During the mayoral campaign, I think. Backed up by the Atlanta Rhythm Section, Al Hurt, and the Uh-Oh Walla Walla Gang Bang Chorus and Chorale, Mayor Stansberry sang two versions of Brenda Lee's classic hit, "I'm Sorry." This seemed to satisfy few. Even from the pulpits, the cry was heard.
Thank you, Garrison Little Radio Church, my, of the white wing, and my gospel truth is on the air. Brethren, today's text is from the book of Hominomines. And the angels spake unto the masses, asking, why can't everyone be mayor of Louisville? And the masses spoke unto the angels, saying, because it's hard to put your foot in your mouth when you're caught with your pants down. Oh, brethren, don't you feel the sin and degradation that has taken this city? I've tried, Lord knows I've tried. I've tried to turn you sinners' heads around, ye lustful, crooked, unscrupulous politicians. Your integrity has fallen to that of a politician. Oh, look what ye hath wrought in Washington, Watergate, and Koreagate, and in Louisville, tailgate. I know what you're thinking. If only you lustful fat cats had a man of my stature backing up some of your lies. Why, if I had spoke out before all this broke out and said, yay, the Lord told me Stansberry was in Atlanta, and the whole subject would have been dropped, and the newspaper would not have pursued it any further. So right now, I want all you lustful public servants out there to put heaven on your side, friends. With the right reverence, sweep the love bug under the rug. Alibi for your lie. Avoid the public outcry. Blessing of tenure in your office. I want you right now to get that green sand of the salvation right in here to Radio 84. In care of the right reverend Deuteronomy Skaggs. Now you politicians, listen up and save your seats. Say amen, flock. Back to you, Gersh.
At Burbank Savings and Laundry, we care about you. Here's one of our satisfied customers.
Yeah, when our daughter entered college 4 years ago, we knew we'd like to send her on a trip to Europe as a graduation present, but heck, that'd cost $2,500, and we didn't have that much money.
So what did you do?
Well, we thought about knocking over a gas station, but then we talked to our savings counselor at Burbank Savings and Laundry, and we found out how easy it'd be to save up for a trip. And it worked like a charm.
It did?
Oh, yeah. All we did was deposit $100 a day for 26 days in a special account at Burbank's. And then, 4 years later, they gave us back every single penny we put in, minus a $100 handling charge.
Oh.
And boy, was our daughter surprised when we gave her that airplane ticket on graduation day.
I bet she was.
Oh, yeah. And she was even more surprised when she got to Europe and discovered the ticket was only good for one way, and that while she was gone, we had her declared legally dead and obtained control of the inheritance she was supposed to get from her grandma.
That's wonderful.
And you know, we never could have pulled it off without help from our friends at Burbank Savings and Laundry.
That's Burbank Savings and Laundry, located in the Volkswagen Microbus at the corner of 1st and Main. Remember, Burbank Savings and Laundry. We take your money for a ride. X member FDIC.
We have been asking you to come by for your swine flu vaccine. We are no longer asking, we are now telling. You will.
I'm here to have my swine shot.
Dateline, Indiaki, early 1979. I'm Bass Ackwards. Over 10 hats, one bonnet, and one halo thrown into the ring for the gubernatorial nomination. The bonnet belongs to Thelma Stovall. The halo, of course, Harvey Sloan's. Harvey Sloan, past star of City Hall in a radio soap opera that followed his career, beginning with Dr. Doctor, then Dr. Mayor, then Dr. X-Mayor, to Dr. Next Governor, to Dr. X Next Governor. Let's back up to Dr. Next Governor. And now, the Gary Burbank Program and the makers of soap present the seemingly never-ending story of...
Dr. Next Governor! Dr. Next Governor!
The true-life drama of how a successful baby doctor had to give up his practice when he became an adult. Let's join Dr. Next Governor as he's speaking to his patient, patient Stansberry.
What seems to be the problem? Well, I've got in this position. I can't seem to uncross my legs. Oh, how did this happen, Mayor?
Well, you see, I had my legs crossed around my chair because I thought there were some people that might come in and try to unseat me any day now. And I had my legs crossed around my chair so they couldn't get them loose, but now I got them stuck like this.
Okay, Nurse Vesuvius?
Yes, Doctor?
We have to help the mayor get his legs uncrossed here.
Of course.
Okay, I need your help here. Okay, let's see. Let's put his left foot in.
His left foot in.
Say, okay. Okay, now put his left foot out.
Oh, his left foot out.
Out here. Okay. Now put his right foot in.
His right foot in.
This hurts a little.
And you shake it all about.
Say, what are you doing?
You do the hokey-pokey egg.
Don't sing over my leg.
And that's what it's all about.
Will this program get any sillier? You can count on it. Be here next time when we hear patient Stansberry say...
I certainly hope the aldermen remember to submit that petition to recall me. Because if they forget, then they'll probably be unable to recall.
And will the aldermen be able to rehabilitate the mayor, even though he was never habilitated to begin with? Tune in next time on...
Dr. Next Governor! Dr. Next Governor! Doom, doom.
This is your Penasker, Gary Burbank, speaking. The Energy Savers of America, a WHAS radio series devoted to highlighting these people who, using Native American ingenuity, cleverness, and pure dumb luck, have developed alternate sources of energy. This is your reporter, Jim Jim. Now, do those things bite?
Oh, no, it's right.
Well, I'm here with chicken farmer Dooley Squat, who has found a new way to power his automobile. How'd you get started, Dooley?
Well, me and my brother Berkeley, we bought a 1940 Hudson about 15 years ago, and Daddy, he said it was a real good car because it run on chicken seed. Oh. Now, of course, I knew what he meant. He meant that real cheap, you know, but my brother Burpee, he ain't too bright. He thought Daddy was serious, and he shoveled some seed down in the gas tank. Of course, all that seed just gummed up engine real bad, and we had to get the seed out of there.
So what did you do?
Well, we figured we could slip a couple of baby chicks down there in the gas tank, let them, you know, peck out all the seed. Worked real good, too. Of course, once the chicks got in there, there wasn't no way to get them out, though. But that was okay, because I'd heard, from what you can see, methane gas, you know, chicken...
Right.
Could be used to power your car. And aside from eggs, that's what chickens produce best is, you know.
Well, how does this chicken, you know what, work?
Well, we just pour some laxative-coated chicken seed in the gas tank, and them birds gobble it up, and we get our methane. Burns real clean, too. No smog.
I understand you're planning to go commercial now.
Yeah, sure. There's our test model cars. Now, this one here gets 22 miles of chicken to the city and 34 miles of chicken on the road.
That's a Pinto.
Yeah, and this near won't blow up either when it gets hit from behind. Of course, it will put chicken feathers all over your windshield of the car that hits you, though, if they hit you from behind.
Aren't those, that's a duck sound effect in the background. You're supposed to have a chicken's.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. Let me switch it over to a chicken sound effect.
No way you talk.
And I asked the woman, says, now over here you take is our luxury model car. Now you need two chickens in a tank to power this. But not only will they power your car, but they'll give you fresh eggs every day.
Well, that's amazing.
They only give you hard-boiled eggs, though.
Well, that's still very good, and thank you. You're a very helpful inflation fighter.
Yeah, them eggs, they just kind of shoot right out the tailpipe.
Hey, that's incredible. Well, thank you, Farmer Dooley Squat, another energy saver of America.
Goodbye, sir.
And as I walk away, I can't help but think about these great energy savers of America.
Sir, you're stepping all in that gasoline we have here.
Oh, yes. This is your reporter, Jim Jim, reporting. There you go.
Dateline, Indiaki Still, pre-election 1979. Dr. Next Governor wasn't in the race for the Democratic nomination for governor by himself. By now, John Y. Brown had thrown his hat into the ring, head and all. And speaking of a head, the front runner at that time, Lieutenant Governor Thelma Stovall. She was the rage. Why, even Scott and Joe Linda included her in a new type disco break.
You hear that music, and you know it's time for another gubernatorial disco break.
Hi, I'm Joe Linda.
And I'm Scott.
Today we're going to learn the Thelma Stovall Front Runner Foxtrot.
Now, girls, this is your dance. You get to lead the guys.
Take his hand and step forward. And now on the fourth step forward, knee your partner in the groin and yell, Vito!
Now with the music, 2, 3, 4, 1.
Forward.
We'll be right back after this word.
We're brought to you by Comatose, the only headache remedy that will get you through all the political speeches. Ease your aching head with Comatose.
That's it for this time.
See you next time.
That's it.
This has been another gubernatorial fiasco.
Like to cut down on pollution, get to work faster, and save gas? Then ride Snark, the snorkel authority of River City. Our train of frogmen swims routes from the Ohio paralleled I-71 for you East End commuters. And for those in the Pleasure Ridge Park area, it's just a short upstream swim on Snark. So grab the flipper of a friend and find out why ride sharing on Snark is such fun. Grab something else besides a flipper and it could be even more fun. Remember, one Snark frogman can take the place of one car, providing you don't mind dodging a few logs and beer cans. For those in the Preston Highway area, Snark's Express run through the sewers and septic tanks of southern Jefferson County and can save you gas and cut down on pollution, since you'll absorb most of it during your trip. For route and schedule information, dial Snark and listen to our busy signal. Snark, the snorkel authority of River City.
It's April 1979. Meanwhile, back at the gubernatorial primary, political hype.
Now, a totally unsolicited and unwanted campaign ad. Now that the General Assembly is over, it's time for the gubernatorial campaign to begin in earnest. And leading the pack,
it's a bird.
It's a steep plane.
No, it's Thelma. Faster than a state plane. More powerful than an incumbent governor. Able to assemble legislators with a single call. It's Thelma!
Terrific spot, but no help. As Thelma Stovall loses the primary, Dr. Next Governor becomes Dr. X Next Governor, and John Y. Brown knocked up victory after victory. More details later on Ladder.
I think it's choked up victory.
That's what I said.
WHAS now presents a Channel 11 editorial. Here is Godfather Don Roberto Morse.
Thank you. Today, I make my choice for governor. You know, I give this a whole lot of thought, all the way through lunch. I think, because I like his face, Louis B. Nunn. And if you look closely, we resemble. We both are big and handsome in a rugged sort of way. And in my opinion, this state need a rugged, handsome governor. It's about time. I say, why not?
That's good thinking, boys.
Right. So we're going to support the Louis B. Nunn. And I also like that little wrinkle he got right above his... Ella, Don Roberto.
Yes, hello, Mr. Moss. This is Mr. Bingham speaking.
Mamma mia.
I want you to wait just a moment. Now, on television, you editorially sided with John Y. Brown.
You want me to plug him, boss?
Be quiet. You get us both plugged.
Now, Don Roberto, you cannot support one candidate on television and the other on radio.
Why not? I think that's a fair.
But you can't do that. If you support Brown on television, you have to also support him on radio.
Yeah, we do that, and none wins, huh? We ain't got no friends.
What?
I mean, you gotta have friends in the capital. You know, you gotta have friends.
Don Roberto, do it my way, or you can't support anyone.
Okay. Oh, he don't know nothing about running no conglomerate.
Boy, I hate to be around you the rest of the day, boss.
What's that?
Nothing.
By the way, fellas, if you're through here, I'd like to use the telephone to play a trick-or-treat gotcha, if you don't...
Shoot the phone, Vinny!
I'll have fun on your gotcha.
Boy, what am I telling you that...
Oh. I almost forgot! Have a happy day!
Hey, Grandpa! What's that down there?
I don't know, son. Let's go down and have a closer look. Why, wait a minute. That's a car, sonny.
What's a car, Grandpa?
Well, son, back years ago, men used to drive cars all over the place till they found out about pollution. And, hey, the lights are still on. Wait a minute. Let me try to start this little keys around here. Wait. Hey, sonny, this thing is still running.
Cut, cut! Hey, what's the old man, the kid, doing in here? Hey. It's so you can't do a battery commercial anymore. That's some yo-yos coming in and getting in the way.
Wait a minute, wait, this here is a snark commercial.
No, it's not. It's for the Smears Die Slowly battery.
No, it's a snark commercial.
Get out of here with that crummy
no,
kid.
No,
get
it, out. We're it's supposed Smears to be here for the snark commercial.
You and battery. Commercial. Oh,
meanwhile, the people of Indiaki buried their past political differences and opened their selfless hearts and arms and said to the rest of the nation, give us your tired, your poor, your huddled masses. Well, never mind, you're poor. Two out of three ain't too bad.
Hello, WHAS.
Mr. Mitch?
No.
This is Eunice and Bernie.
No, it's Gary Burbank.
According to your topic, you know, talking about how people always make an extra buck off the suckers in town for the Derby Week.
I'm not talking about
well,
that.
We detest that. We think it's
well, that's commendable. That's
yeah,
commendable.
We're
thank you.
We're calling today, Mr. Mitch, to tell people about our miracle memory course. Tell
what?
Them,
why would you want to call about... What?
Now, you know, you'll be wanting to bet on a horse for the Derby, and you don't get to remember, maybe you can't remember the horse's name,
right.
Or you know how many seconds it took him to run the back stretch.
Yeah,
the
you have to figure
draw,
up all that stuff to see if he's going to make it, yeah.
Well, if you have a bad memory and you wish you could recall little details, well, now you can, thanks to our guaranteed memory course.
Yes. Memory course?
And you send us a lot of your money, we'll tell you about our secret amazing technique.
What's that?
It's association.
What do you mean by association?
Well, for example, let's say you want to remember this year's Derby favorite. So you can place a bet on him. The horse's name, I think, is Ed Smith.
Ed Smith is not the horse's name.
That's
spectacular.
The first letter E, and notice that it's the fifth letter of the alphabet.
What?
Notice also that Smith contains five letters. So there's your first association.
What?
Now we reinforce this by looking for others.
Other associations.
Notice the middle three letters of Smith spell Mitt.
Yeah.
In baseball, Mitt.
Well, that's,
of course,
that's two T's.
Mitt is actually spelled what you feel in your head, and by golly, head rhymes with Ed.
Head and
the horse's
Ed.
First name.
The horse's name is Ed Smith.
Well, that did send us a lot of money for the Eunice and Bernice Miracle Memory Course in care of this station.
Yeah.
Remember, eight rhymes with great, so don't you wait and be late, and we'll pay the freight. Order now before you forget.
For the memory course, you girls don't want to make any money off people, though, do you? Not the Derby.
We hate people that try to make money off the tourists in town.
Oh, but you would never do that.
Terrible.
That's terrible.
Terrible, terrible, terrible.
Terrible, huh?
Yes.
Terrible. Bye, girls.
Mitch.
Yes, nice talk. Ladies and gentlemen, Rodney Floyd.
Thank you so much. And welcome to hearing me. Shoot. Well, it's early spring now, 1979. Not quite springtime. The first time any of us ever heard about salt, too. Now, I ain't talking about no salt you pour on a snail and watch him melt. I'm talking about weapons. Get that, Gary.
Hello, WHAS.
Hello there, Gary. This here is Arnie Bernal.
Well, how you doing, Arnie Barnell?
I'm doing pretty good. You know, I heard you talking about on this date in history, and I thought I might call you up here. I had a couple of atoms here in 1326.
What happened?
Perseus Sidestepper invented the gun.
Really? Perseus Sidestepper?
Yeah. Now, this had the effect, Gary, of shortening army battles considerably.
Oh.
Yeah, because prior to this time, you know, soldiers had to throw their bullets at the enemy.
Oh, that's really interesting, and thank you so much for calling, Arnie.
That's all right, and if I think of anything else, I'll be the first to call.
I appreciate that.
Bye.
Hello, WHAS.
Yeah, so Arnie Barnell again.
Yeah.
You know, I told you if I thought of anything else, I'd be the first to call. And, you know, I thought about this. Now, you know, it was on this date in history, Gary, that in 1503, I think, if I remember back correctly.
1503?
Yeah. Leonardo da Vinci got the model for the Mona Lisa to give that famous smile by doing something.
What was that?
By whispering to her these immortal words. Just pretend, baby, that I'm not naked.
Thanks a lot, Arnie.
Yes, all right. Now, I'll talk to you if I think of anything.
Really sorry, Rodney. Well, I might say it is irritable. But getting back to Salt, too.
Honk, honk, time for a commercial.
Oh, Beulah the Buzzard's honking for a commercial. Well, if you gotta be here, you might as well be bought by somebody.
Running for today, brought to you by the Optimist Club, who remind you that this week's meeting of the Durable Optimist Club will be held on Friday. Unless it rains, or there's some awful earthquake, or some terrible tragedy strikes that the Optimist Club doesn't know about. You know, like if the world was to end, then there would be no Optimist Club meeting. Otherwise, if none of these terrible tragedies take place, there will be a meeting of the Optimist Club on Friday.
Mighty fine job, yeah, thank you. Well, getting back to Salt, too. Well, this time of the year, Salt 2 wasn't too popular, and President Carter had to do some heavy promoting. Why, he even stooped to calling a lowly radio program.
Yes, I do have nice hair on my chest, though, and it did show good, you know, with the toga.
I see.
But I digress. Actually, Gary, I called to talk to you, ask you what you thought about my speech.
Well, I thought it was quite a speech.
Well, thank you. I thank you for that. I particularly wanted to build some support for the Salt 2 Treaty.
Yes, sir.
But see, I know that many people won't listen to political speeches, so I'm preparing another method of showing the support of the American people for this treaty.
What's that?
Well, I've gathered at the White House several cheerleading squads here.
Cheerleading squads?
Yes, they were stranded at the airport because of the snowstorm we had over here. Now, we worked out some cheers, and I think that you ought to hear this, and the whole world should hear this. That's why I've called you.
A cheerleading squad?
Yes. So this is going to be a new thing in politics. I'm sure it's going to catch on now. Okay, gang, if you're ready here. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Brezhnev, he's our man. If he can't do it, Jimmy can.
What?
Jimmy, he's our man. If he can't do it, nobody can.
Sir. Give me an S. Give me an A. Give me an L. Give me a T.
T.
Salt two. That's the treaty for me.
Yay!
Hello, sir.
Gary, what you think of that there?
Well, I think it would be at least as popular as the win button.
Oh, good. Well, listen, Gary, I have affairs of state, matters of state, and state of matters to attend to here. Not to mention, I've got to write some new cheers.
Yes, sir.
And I'll talk to you later.
Goodbye, sir.
Goodbye.
This just in, the government announced today that for the first time in history, there isn't a dime's worth of difference between a nickel and a quarter. Page two.
I'm so embarrassed. I didn't know. You're on the extension now?
I'm sorry. Now I wanted to play your stupid radio contest.
But, ma'am, I'm sorry, too. I had no idea.
It's stuck. How could... The phone is stuck up. This is awful.
Ma'am, I had no idea you were naked when you started playing the contest.
You should have known.
How would I know? We're on the telephone, ma'am.
But the phone is stuck up. Roll tape.
I'm sorry I ever played the stupid contest.
This is your announcer, Gary Burbank, inviting you to win $1 million.
What do I say with my husband?
And I'll start you off with your first team. Where you get the rest is up to you. Today, I will guess your weight by hearing you sit on the phone.
I should never 585-2385
is my number, Johnny.
Call on down.
Good day. Good day. Voice crack. Dateline, Uganda. Item, Ugandan President Idi Gourmet.
This is your pronouncer, Gary Burbank.
At WHAS, we have the up-the-ladder salute. Well, we naturally also have the down-the-ladder salute. It's time now for today's WHAS down-the-ladder salute. Today's down-the-ladder salute goes to Ugandan leader Idi Amin, who is due to be tossed out of office as soon as the Tanzanian army arrives in the Ugandan capital. Well, in honor of this occasion, Idi, we're giving you a free dinner at Honest Fred's Missionary Burger Carryout, home of the hot and juicy Jesuit burger that comes on a toasted bun and Fred's secret missionary sauce. That's Fred's sign of the golden haunches. This has been another down-the-ladder salute. Hello, WHAS.
Yes, Mr. Burbank, this is Idi Amin, supreme ruler, obnoxious know-it-all, total boss man of Uganda, at least for now.
Yes, sir, what can I do for you?
Thank you for down the ladder salute.
Yes, sir, I hope you enjoy the meal.
Well, as you know, I'll probably soon be leaving Uganda for extended vacation. I need ready cash.
Well, sir, credit cards are awfully convenient when you're out of town. Why do you need cash?
Well, bank told me my credit rating about zip.
Yeah.
I offered to do TV commercial for them, but they're not interested.
A TV commercial?
Yes, you know. The one that go in my native country, everyone knew me on sight. But now I'm out of office. I totally ignore it, but not with this credit card. Don't leave home without it.
It's an interesting idea, but I don't think they're going to want you on that commercial, sir.
This is not why I call.
Why is that, sir?
Well, I'm having Idi Amin going out of business sale.
What are you selling?
Well, first, they be my uniforms.
Uniforms?
Yes, you know, I have several hundred of them. There is the formal white with gold piping double-breasted suit used for receiving my many medals and honors.
Yes.
Now, normally, this would go about $5,000 because the gold piping is real. But if you call me this week only, I will go for it only $19.98. I give discount because all pinholes from medals.
Yeah, I guess the medals make holes in the uniforms and brings down the price.
Oh, yes.
What about the medals? Why, you should include them.
I had not thought of that. Perhaps I should. I sell them to $5 each.
That's quite a bargain.
Oh, yes. You look like ruler without having been one. Think how intimidated you boss would be when you put on this suit, walk into office, and demand a raise.
Hey, that would be quite a scene.
And just in case you boss is excitable type, this suit has bulletproof lining panels sewn in there.
I see. What else are you selling?
Well, they always the cheering.
The cheering?
Yes, the cheering. Yes. Like my uniform, I have several hundred cheering as well. Think how much fun it would be to raise little prince or princess. Even if I'm not in office, they'd be quite conversation piece among the neighbors, eh?
Anything else?
Oh, yes. This last item, really for limited time only, I have set of commemorative Ugandan stamps.
What do they commemorate?
This set commemorate Israeli raid on Entebbe Airport, and the brave Ugandan soldiers chased them away.
Wait a minute, that's not what happened.
Of course not, but who wants a set of stamps commemorating Israeli soldiers making fool of me?
Well, I can think of a few. Thank you for calling, sir.
My pleasure. Remember, this sale go on until the Tanzania arrive in Uganda. No credit cards, no party checks. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Good day. This is Bass Ackwards.
Memories, memories.
We're going back in time now. From oldie, oldie news story.
Memories.
A blast.
Memories.
From the past.
Ringing in my ears.
Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, Three Mile Island.
It's interview time. And today's interview, since Three Mile Island is in the news, and this is what's happening in the country today, will be with Dr. T-Bone Whittington III, nuclear physicist and blues singer. Now, Dr. Whittington has not had a chance to sing his blues on the radio so people would buy his records. Therefore, we'll interview Dr. Whittington and combine this interview with one of his tunes.
And he will sing his replies to my pertinent and impertinent questions. First of all, Doctor, let me ask you, as a nuclear physicist, in your opinion, do you think that the public is in any danger from this nuclear accident in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania? What is your opinion, sir? And what do you think of this? Yes, sir. I see. Is the public being totally informed, sir? You're informing them now. I see. Yes, sir. Well, could this happen anywhere else in the country, say like Marble Hill? Do you think it could happen there, sir? Uh-huh. Yeah, well, who's responsible for this, sir? Who should take the blame for this accident?
think so, sir. Well, I don't know. Well, is nuclear power really safe, sir? What do you think should happen here?
Let it go! Let it go! Let it go!
Yes.
Let it go!
Let it go, yes, sir.
Don't believe I can take much more. Let it go.
Thank you so much for your comments, sir. I'm sure that you have made as much sense as any person or any spokesman for the Nuclear Regulatory Commission that I've heard so far on TV, and I think this is a very insightful type interview, and I thank you for being on my program today and committing yourself to being so succinct. Thank you, sir, very much. Yes, thank you, sir. This is Gary Burbank on today's interview, interviewing blues singer and nuclear physicist T-Bone Whittington III. This has been a public... Sir, just a moment. Sir.
And now, WHAS presents our highly unclaimed series, How to Conserve Gasoline, with energy expert, Sheik Ratel and Roll.
Get out of that car and
rattle them punks in the
house.
Attaboy
there. Good you want it.
Hi there, neighbors. This here is Orny Bartle. I'm the interpreter for a Sheik Ratel and Roll because he can't speak no good English. But I interpret, and you can give us a call. This here is a call-in show. Any questions you have about energy, and Sheik Ratel and Roll will be glad to answer, right? Well, there's a call. He says hello.
Well, ask the Sheik this. Hello, Sheik. Tell me about, you know, I've heard about asking the utility company to make a thermogram of your home. Now, what is this thermogram stuff?
The Sheik says that they will fly over your house in a helicopter. And then they will take a picture, an infrared picture that shows where the heat is escaping. And the Sheik says that most utilities companies will provide this service free.
How nice.
He says the way they can provide this service free is the utility company simply raise everyone's utility rates.
But that ain't exactly free. What'd he say?
I don't think you want to hear that, ma'am.
Hope your time is up, Sheik, honey.
Oh, Sheik, and neighbors, I guess our time is up. Any last words here? The Sheik says, remember, neighbors, that more than half the money you spend on heating may be wasted. One method of doing something about this is to sue the company that built your home. The Sheik says this method is recommended by 4 out of 5 attorneys. Well, attorneys have to eat. This here is Arnie Barnold for the Sheik Rat Tail and Roll. Adios, neighbors.
The English.
Oh, the Sheik won't say one thing in English.
Keep you coming humping.
Well, has anybody heard just when the Skylab is supposed to fall? Me? I want plenty of time to panic. I love the way NASA put it. Skylab will fall sometime this summer. Can you believe that? Shoot. This thing's going to scatter 85 tons of hot metal over 3,500-mile area. And they say, sometime this summer. What are they going to do, wait for Chicken Little to warn us?
Oh, hello, brethren and sister, and thank you, Garish. Let me ask you this, flock. When Skylab changes from a piece of pious progress into pagan projectiles of painful puncture, are you going to become Swiss cheese? Yeah. Will Wayland White hot metal whistle Dixie through your mangled mortal body spray? Will y'all try to outrun them rockets of ruin or stand up proud and pontifical against that molten mass of meteoric misfortune, friend? Well, flock, what you need is the Reverend Deuteronomy Skaggs, Aerospace Save Your Face, Anti-Skylab Suit of Safety and Sanctification, say amen, flock. Close enough. Yes, brethren and sisters, when that 2,000-pound airlock of ethereal reentry screams out of the sky, whoop, hallelujah, the anti-Skylab suit will be your apostolic armor against the heat of Hades and them lacerations of Lucifer, friend. Because y'all will be reinforced by the iron of Isaiah, I say, the might of Moses, whoop, hallelujah, friend.
all of this for the meteorically minuscule amount of $11.17. Neighbor, I want you right now to sail that capsule of contribution round my altar frame. Don't make me holler, don't make me shout. Turn them pockets inside out. Whoop, hallelujah, and shoot your lip to the Lord. Say amen, block. Close enough, back to you, guys.
I'm not that average, sir.
Well, compared to me.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Well, the public is into this nostalgia thing, right?
Well, sir, I've always thought that nostalgia is a thing of the past.
Yeah, but it might work, Gary. Let's say now that I made a 50s-type musical record, so when I find someone in the cabinet, I could sing my lines with the music. Well, Gary, it would be the first executive decree people could dance to.
Why, that might work out. It could go over good with a disco crowd, an executive decree you could dance to.
Yes, I'll give you an example here. I brought my bass singer with me, and this is how it would sound when I got on TV and made my announcements of my latest firings. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Get a job, cha-na-na-na, cha-na-na-na, cha-na-na-na-na.
When I wake up in the morning, I feel like firing. You better listen up, you might need hiring.
Get a job, cha-na-na-na.
Okay, your name may be here.
Get a job.
Joseph Califano.
Get a job.
Michael Blumenthal.
Get a job.
Brock Adams.
Get a job.
James Schlesinger. And Griffin Bell. All of you.
Get a job.
Hello, WHAS.
Oh, yes. Hello, counselor.
No, I'm not.
Yes, listen, counselor, I want you to help me out here. I need a little help here. No, I may not want to go to court, you understand.
I'm busy right now.
Yes, yeah, I was driving last night with my old lady, Seldes.
Right.
And I got this ticket for speeding.
Oh,
yes, right. And I was going 110 miles an hour.
Well,
yeah, we got to go to court on this thing.
Well, no, you can't win. You can't go 110
yeah,
miles an hour.
The speed limit is 55 miles an hour.
Right.
But see, I had my old lady with me. There was two people. Yeah. And the speed limit is, what, 55 miles per hour per person?
No, it's
now,
not.
Making 110 miles per hour.
It's not per person.
Man,
that's
I wouldn't go to the speed limit
that's
because
stupid.
There was two of us in the car, you understand?
No, you can't.
Yeah.
No, it is not
but
that.
I'll see you in court, Jack.
Me?
Yeah, well, I'll take you. I'll sue you, too.
Hello, WHAS.
Yes, hello, Gary. It's JC.
Mr. President, it's so good to hear from you again, sir.
It's been a while. I've been very busy, involved with the Salt 2 Tops, Gary.
Yes, sir, I know. Well, how's it going?
First of all, Gary, on this telephone call, I'd like to address myself to something that happened last week. A lot of reporters got a big charge out of saying that I said if there was an election, I would whip Ted Kennedy's... I did not say that, Gary.
I didn't think you did, sir. What did you really say?
What I said, Gary, was this. If we were to go fishing, I would beat his bass.
Carter reminds me of those beer commercials. What we've always wanted in a president and less... Thank you, my constituents.
Well, that's it. Nothing much happened this summer, except the campaigning. We'll cover that later. Boy, summer went by fast this year. Would have gone by even faster, though, if Mayor Billy toward the end hadn't taken that allegedly unauthorized trip. This time it was Florida, I think. And, of course, the media charlatans hopped on his case.
Hi, I'm Norm Lewis. Blue farewell song. Okay, come on, y'all. Ready.
Won't you come home, Mayor Billy? Won't you come home? You've been messing around the sunny Southland. You said my money was low.
I see you laying on the beach in Florida.
Uh-oh.
You could have taken me along.
Mayor Billy, next time you take a trip down south,
take the city along.
Won't you come home, Mayor Billy? We need you near. Why, I'm not quite sure, but you ought to be here.
You did the cooking. Mary Ellen paid the rent, though.
You took the vacation, but it was my tax dollars you just spent.
Come on. You remember this rainy evening when the alderman taught you out? But don't resign, Billy boy. They only punk aldermen. And the mayor's got so much more clout, you know.
And if you leave, all of Louisville will frown.
Cause ain't nobody, to replace our beloved town clown.
They say you're to blame, but then, you gotta see fame. Mayor Billy, won't you please stay home?
this is the record.
Yes, hello, record. This is J.C., Calvin.
Yes, sir.
You know, I heard you sing that song about Mayor Billy, Please Stay Home, and I thought that maybe it might be a good idea to afford his opponents an equal time here to tell him to get lost.
Oh, well, you're probably right, sir, and with us in the studio is Rodney Floyd and the Alderman to sing the opposing viewpoint on this song.
Well, that'll be fine. I look forward to hearing that now.
It's coming up right.
Ladies and gentlemen, the new singing sensation, Rodney Floyd, Mr. Bingham, and the Alderman.
Won't you get lost, Mayor Billy? Won't you get lost?
Shoot. Oh, please, won't you leave town?
I come in here, Mayor Billy. Every time you leave, you always turn up found.
We remember that trip last summer during the fireman's strike.
We thought you'd learned your lesson then, but once again you had to take a hike.
Oh boy.
But I guess you never learn, and you get what you earn. So Mayor Billy, won't you in your term?
Don't listen to the Mayor Billy. Don't resign. Take it from one who knows. Besides, I haven't found many people that can pull more boners than myself, and I want to be there. Go down with the ship. Let me make this perfectly clear. Go down with the ship, Mayor Billy.
The time, fall 1979. Turning from all the political strife in the world, America escaped into the World Series. Good old World Series. Trouble was, TV night games didn't end till 2 o'clock in the morning. And everyone had a different reason why. Well, Channel 11 godfather and general manager Don Roberto Morse had his pulse on the finger of the problem. Finger on the pulse.
You know, it occurred to me the reason the World Series night games last so late is because it takes so long to sing the national anthem. I mean, you think those people expect someone to write a movie about their lives after they sing? That's why today we're going to have the Sing the National Anthem at next year's World Series contest. Our entrants are standing by and ready. First, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Robert Goulet will sing the National Anthem.
There you go. Oh, 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 let's see. Oh, 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 oh,
say.
Oh, oh, say, say.
Say, can you?
Oh, say, can you?
Next.
Oh, jubop, jubada-bada, shoo-jubop-wop. Oh, say, 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 say.
Next.
And now to sing our national anthem, Marvin Gray.
Whoa, baby, get down. Hey, get down, don't you? See.
At that rate, it would have taken him an hour and a half to sing the song.
You better hurry and find somebody, boys. I'm running out of bullets.
Next.
Our next contestant, little 27-year-old Wilson Jeter. Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem.
Oh, say, can you see brothers? Bring home the break.
We found it,
boys. Thanks for moving, boys.
Now, say, that's the way the national anthem ought to be sung, so we get on with the game. But perhaps you have a positive viewpoint.
And perhaps you'd like to enter next year's contest.
Vinny got a point. This is Godfather Don Roberto Morse. Have a happy day.
In the fall of 1979, Don Roberto Morse and his TV lab mafia barely missed a Nobel Peace Prize when they came up with The Guide to Discriminatory Language. And Don Roberto's implementation of the Semantic Police Watchdog of Improper References. I'll never forget during the World Series.
Willie Stargell at bat, and here we go. There's a hot grounder to the shortstop. And
hold it, hold it.
What?
Shortstop discriminates against short people. The phrase now is mid-stop or simply stop.
Okay.
And it caused quite a problem for disc jockeys, too.
And now, here's Peter, Bob, and Mary, Ladybug, Ladybug, Fly Away Home.
Hold it. You can't say ladybug. Lady is a judgmental term. From now on, make it person bug, fly away home.
Oh, you're right. Peter Bonaneri and person bug, fly away home.
And the semantic police caused quite a problem concerning affairs also.
Oh, darling,
Darling, I love you.
No, I'm sorry. Darling is no longer approved. The acceptable phrase is the person's name. Try it again.
Oh, person's name. I love you.
That's better. I love you, too. It's time now for another entrant in the Burbank Gossip Hall of Fame from WHAS. Today's award goes to Mrs. Belle Ringer of Springer, Kentucky. Mrs. Ringer was solely responsible for the tragic whispering campaign in 1974, I'm sure we all remember, that resulted in the breakup of 32 engagements, destroying 19 marriages, ruining the reputations of 45 single women, all named Vi, by the way, and damaging the careers of 29 young businesswomen and men. Mrs. Ringer was eventually shamed out of Kentucky and is now living with her lips stapled together with the stipulation that she must never gossip again or her head will be melted down and sold at auction. On the phone with me now is Miss Ringer. Your lips are stapled together, that's right. Well, Miss Ringer, how do you feel about being chosen as another entrant in the Gossip Hall of Fame? What? You're all excited. Thank you. Good. Well, we would like to send you a handmade gossiping flag showing two giant flapping lips over a field of crossed telephone wires. Thank you, Miss Springer. Goodbye. Say there, busy executive. Wouldn't you like to be able to make use of time you normally waste? You know, times like when you're caught in a traffic jam or waiting for a judge to set bail for your kids. Wouldn't it be great if you could use those times to take care of your correspondence, dictate speeches, or record notes to yourself? Well, now you can, thanks to Burbank's all-new Pocket Secretary. Yes, Burbank has come up with something brand new. This is not just another one of those dumb little tape recorders. This is a real Pocket Secretary.
Hi there. Yes, I'm a living, breathing, exceptionally small human being who takes 210 words a minute shorthand. I type 95 words per minute, and I make a pretty mean little cup of coffee, too. Before you leave the office, just pop me into your pocket, and you're ready to work anywhere at any time. Just watch where you sit.
Okay, back into my pocket. Sorry, babe, it comes with the job.
Ring, ring.
Yellow.
Yeah, this is Sporky Tedwig. Thought we'd shake your tree this afternoon discussing your topic. You know, speaking of football again, that's all you want to talk about here lately.
I don't have a topic.
Well, sorry, me, because I got another football game on tonight. Yes, I love football myself, personally.
I feel the same way, yes.
But you know what I think, though?
What?
I think, personally, myself, you know, I played football when I was a child.
You did?
Yes, I was a football player. Oh. But you know, our games was much more exciting than the NFL.
Why do you say that? They shouldn't be. That's professional.
Because our pigskin still had a pig in it.
Had a pig? Come on.
No, that's true stuff. Yes.
No,
it was very exciting.
You played with a pig?
It wasn't very easy, though.
Well, how was that?
I mean, if you ever tried a flea flicker with a pig.
I can imagine, yes.
And we had a lot of fumbles, too, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Only in our case, it was called coughing up the pig.
I see. Yes, that's what it would be called, I guess.
That's my brother, Eugene.
Right. Okay, well, look.
He thinks I'm the daddy or the radio, you
understand? Yes, sir. Okay.
Yes, you know, but you know, when you're playing with a pig and not really a pig skin, you know, you have to be very careful recovering the pig too after the fumble.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, a little devil could bite.
Mm.
Oh, yeah, you go jump on him. She hurts you.
Yes, sir. Okay,
but
thank you.
But a pig could also slow down your passing game. Mr. Metz. I mean, you know, our quarterback, he could throw a perfect spiral with that pig.
Really?
Nobody wanted to catch it.
Why not?
Well, because it usually made the pig sick. You know, he's throwing a pig, he's throwing a spiral, you know. You catch it, you know, the pig...
Okay, thank
all
you.
Over you, you know,
I understand, yes, sir.
Around in the air.
Right, right, okay.
Our ends used to change uniforms 4 or 5 times a game.
Oh, for sure, yeah, I can see.
Oh, yes,
thank
and
you.
The punter. It was rough on them, you know, because sometimes when you try to punt a pig, you know, your foot gets stuck.
Naturally.
I'm better to tell you that on the railroad,
right. Okay,
though.
Please don't. Radio.
Yeah, well, Mr. Metz, it's been real nice conversing on your topic.
I'm not Mr. Metz.
The folks in the audience and your... I'll see you later, Bubba.
Why, hello. I'm Mrs. Burbank. If you're a parent, you know how you can worry about your child. You know that accidents happen easily. And if you're like most parents, one of your biggest fears is that one day you might accidentally throw your baby out with the bathwater. Well, now your worries are over, thanks to Mrs. Burbank's Baby Savers. Yes, Mrs. Burbank's Baby Savers is a patented rubber suction device that allows you to temporarily, but firmly, attach your baby to the side of the tub, to the soap dish, or to the ceiling. Just pull the plug to the drain, and your baby stays high, dry, and safe, while your dirty bathwater beats a hasty retreat. So why court disaster any longer? Order your Baby Saver today. Send $9.95 to Mrs. Burbank Baby Savers, Battle Bath, Michigan, member FDIC, also member, this is WHANS, Louisville.
Welcome, friends, to ABC 2020
ABC.
TV.
ABC,
the 2020 newscast with Hugh Downs.
Wait a minute, this is ABC. We're a CBS affiliate. How'd ABC get in
Thank
here?
Thank you, Morley.
Hey, wait.
Well, this is Hugh Downs at 2020, where you can believe in television.
You better get somebody in
We're
here.
All professional journalists and
ABC
only report the facts.
What's wrong
this
here?
Is our main mission in ABC. TV news, only the facts.
With this in mind,
this report with Geraldo Rivera.
Thank you very much, Hugh Downs. This is Geraldo Rivera. And today we're going to check into the story, the Hamilton Jordan used cocaine at Studio 54. We have some people to interview. Did he use the cocaine or not? I am talking to his friend. We will not mention the name. You went to Studio 54 with Hamilton Jordan. Did he use the cocaine or not?
I can positively, irrefutably, no question about it, say, I think so.
And how about the owner of Cloud 55? Did you see Hamilton Jordan use the cocaine?
Will this get me less time in prison?
I don't know.
I saw him. Okay, yeah, I say yes.
Pretty conclusive, huh? But we have more proof.
We have ABC
Here is the
news.
Man who say that he immersed the cocaine to Hamilton Jordan, Mr. Johnny C. Very outstanding individual.
I did what?
You gave it to him, stupid.
Yeah, I gave it to him. Little short guy.
No, he's a big tall guy.
Oh, yeah, a blonde.
No, he's dark.
Oh, right. I gave it to him.
But what'd you get?
The money.
The cocaine!
Oh, yeah, that too.
Well, that conclusively proves that something happened that night. We feel our obligation to bring that to you. This is Geraldo Rivera. Adios, muchachos.
Why do we have ABC? We're a CBS affiliate.
Thank
I'm
you, Geraldo Rivera. This is Hugh Downs at 2020, reminding you that at this program, we try to be factual. And if we're not factual, may lightning strike. I think things are returning to us now here at WHAS. This is Gary Burbank. We're a CBS affiliate.
I don't know what happened.
I don't need you anymore, Mr. Engineer. We're a CBS affiliate. Suddenly, we ended up with ABC 2020 TV news on there. I do apologize for you folks who thought we were going to have CBS. I was one of them. I apologize to myself. I don't know what happened. Sorry. WHAS, this is your announcer, Gary Burbeck. And now, with a report from the meeting of Superintendent Ernest Grayson and the school board, here is Jim and the action Cam Cam. Come in, Jim.
Yes, thank you, Gary. Well, right now, there seems to be a lot of confusion in this meeting of the school board. Let's go down to Louisville Last Night reporter, Tom Van How Do I Look, for this report. Tom?
Thank you, Jim. Well, from the reports we have, this all started when Anthony Gamboa took three of Ernest Grayson's Crayolas and the coloring book, which Mr. Grayson had not finished yet. Then Miss Haddad and Mr. Dietrich started throwing sand on Mr. Gamboa. Oh, wait a minute. Now Mr. Wooden, is trying to hit Miss Haddad and Mr. Dietrich with Legos.
Hold it.
Mr. Grayson has thrown a whole handful of Tinker Toys at Mr. Gamboa. And well, Jim, I'm afraid the whole scene is getting out of control, so back to you.
Well, thanks to Tom Van How Do I Look for that report. Well, we're going back now. No, wait, Gary, don't take it yet. Something very strange is going on. Yes, hold it. One of the Kentucky Board Observers is going to the piano, and yes, I believe it's music time at the board meeting. Ooh, that should be wonderful. Music time at the school board meeting. Mr. Grayson and the entire board are going to sing now. Let's turn on our microphones, Tom Van How Do I Look, and get this song.
As we always do, we just use the ruse that is tried and true. Broken record to play it every day, and we play it to the kids
the parents and the PTA. Blame it on the rushing order. That is our excuse. Blame it on the rushing order. On Pooh and Dr. Seuss. We're so busy fighting to get our way. Worry about the kids some other day. Blame it on the busing order. It's our excuse. Is it your inept?
No, no, the busing order.
That's not adept.
No, no, the busing order.
Accept.
No, no, the busing order.
That's it's our excuse.
Hello, WHAS.
Yeah, hello, I'd like to talk to Joe Donovan concerning that shopper's guide.
The shopper's exchange every
well,
day on the show.
Normally
yeah, they
listen at when.
Right,
but
that's
I'm
okay.
I'm going to get in on this.
Everyone has their
Yeah. I've been looking around for something, and I can't find it.
But this isn't that, though, see. This
and
isn't
I
the shopper's...
And I want anybody to help me out.
Well, okay,
well,
maybe
I'm,
we can find what you're looking
I'm
for.
I'm looking for a woman.
A woman? No,
yeah.
No.
I went over to Chili Toes the other night.
Yeah, but see...
And hell, they got a woman's department. I went back there, and they said they was all out. They told me they was all out.
Well, yeah.
I'd like a red-headed woman with big, long, fat legs.
I'll tell Joe.
If anybody knows what store I could find one at, I'd appreciate it.
You call Joe Donovan on this.
Yeah,
come to think of it, I don't know.
I'd like to make a final comment.
Comment.
Regarding Fairing Affairs.
What?
No, this is grab bag, isn't it?
It's not grab bag,
well,
no.
I'd just like to say that I am also mad at them Uranians.
Uranians?
Yes, sir. But I still don't think we should deport all Persian cats. I ain't for that.
Okay.
No, sir.
Yeah, okay.
Well,
any
violent woman.
I'll tell Joe.
Yeah, see you later.
Yeah, bye.
This is Barry Bingham. Recently, people have been calling WHAS and saying that Gary Burbank should be taken off the air, that he's becoming uncontrollable. But Mr. Burbank says he believes in free speech, even on the radio. But I must inform you, these people, archaic thinkers that they are, will not take no for an answer. They are outside the station now at this moment, mounted on horseback, and they're armed, waiting to take free speech away. And their main objective is to do away with Gary Burbank. And now with the enemy waiting in ambush for Mr. Burbank, the humble disc jockey sees his beloved comrades, you the people, in danger of losing your constitutional rights. Gary now realizes fully well that sounding his bugle to warn you the people might mean certain death for him. Undaunted and oblivious, though, to consequence, to warn you that irate listeners are riding in, Gary now raises his bugle to his lips.
Thank you.
though I belted you and I flayed you, by the living God that made you, you're a better man than I am, Gunga Gary. This is Barry Bingham speaking from WHAS, Louisville.
Hello, this is Gary Burbank. I'd like to thank you for coming to this album. And before I have a final word, this final word.
Mr. Truck Driver, how do you spell Khomeini?
I spell it R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
Miss Elementary School Teacher, how do you spell Khomeini?
I spell it R-O-L-E-L-O-R-E-O. I spell it R...
Mr. and Mrs. Shopper of America, how do you spell Khomeini?
We spell it R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
Khomeini. We spell it R-O-L-A-I-D-S. Because he gives us gas.
Or at least he used to. Well, thank you very much for coming once again, and you're probably wondering why I'm thanking you on the third side of the album. It should be done on the fourth side, right? If it's a double album. You've been had. There is no fourth side of this album. I know you'll probably go ahead and turn it over just...
Dissolve quad split. Take camera three.
Stand by.
Cue bell.
It's a most unusual day. Feel like throwing my worries away. If my heart won't behave in the usual way, well, there's only one thing to say. It's a most unusual, most unusual, most unusual day.
This is the 1979 Crusade for Children. From Kentuckiana and all across the country have come television and recording stars and hundreds of volunteers who have offered their services. But here are the real Crusade stars, the mentally and physically handicapped children of Kentucky and southern Indiana. Whether or not their lives can be made worthwhile depends on you.
There are people eating people. Spring in the air, the most unusual time. I've been feeling my temperature climb. If my heart won't behave in the usual way, well, there's only one thing to say. It's a most unusual, most unusual, most unusual. Yes, it's a most unusual day.
Ceremonies for the next 24 hours, Mr. Crusade, Jim Walton.
Thank you so much. And this is the reason we're all here tonight, for Sheila Theiler. She needs a helping hand, and I think we're going to give it to her. Tomorrow, when that last diamond dollar has been dropped into the fishbowl, she and thousands like her will say, thank you so much. You've done it again. Speaking of thanks, we'd like to thank some other people. Judy Marshall and Joanne Hale, of course, the Patsy Bluard dancers, Dave Jones and his motet singers, and, of course, our big Crusade Orchestra directed by Mel Owens. Now, you know the purpose of the show. You've been here 25 years with us, I think, most of you. And you know we're here to raise as much money as we possibly can to help as many handicapped children in Kentucky and southern Indiana as we can. And our first entertainer is an actress and recording artist, and Last night, someone said to her, "What are you going to sing?" And I think I can quote her almost verbatim. It was something like, "Honey, I'm going to do it all." Della Reese.
To be alive. Wish away your lonely night. Come on, let's fly. You've been hurt so bad by the lives you've had that you close the door. You've been crying so long that you don't believe that you can laugh anymore. But this is not the part of life, you see. Life is bitter, but life is sweet. Even darkness can bring you light.
What I want to know is, where is the energy shortage, huh?
Oh, listen, that's very sweet. But, I'm going to say this because I'm a stranger in town, and I've only
been
here...
Not a stranger anymore,
well,
I'll tell you that.
Thank you. I've only been here a couple of days, and I've learned a few things about this crusade in the last couple of days and about the people who run this crusade. They worked very hard for this crusade for you, and it's your turn to work very hard and show that their efforts have not been in vain. So while you're sitting there enjoying the show and enjoying the efforts of these people, please call. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Okay, I'm looking over and I'm seeing a man who has all of those gold records. Bobby Rydell. Let's welcome back once again Mr. Dean Shepherd.
More than the greatest love the world has known, this is the love I give to you alone. More than the simple words I try to say, I only live to love you.
on the board right now is 86,948 at about 12 minutes before midnight. This is Miss Yvonne Over.
Memories like the corners of my mind. Misty watercolored memories of the way we were. The way we were.
Is our board fixed back here yet? Yeah, I can read it now. $93,499. This is the fellow who's the all-night DJ, I'll have you know. From WKRP up in Cincinnati, that's just up the pike a piece. And you know him, of course, as Venus Flytrap. Let's welcome Tim Reed. Tim?
That old theme song. I haven't heard that for a while.
Sound familiar?
Oh, yeah. Nice.
Well, what do you think of the kids?
I've fallen in love with a little young girl over there. She's crying now, of course, because I've gone.
You've gone away.
Yep. What's your name again?
April,
all right. And you have some money for me, is that right? Thank you, April. Wow, that's a lot of money. Well, can I get a kiss? It's all about love, isn't it?
Now, welcome Pee Wee King.
I was waltzing with my darling to the Tennessee Wall, when an old friend I happened to see, I introduced him to my loved one the night they were playing the beautiful Tennessee Wall.
Can we do a little camera switch here and go over and find Gary Burbank somewhere with
you? Don't have to find him. Now watch him, Dale.
We're going to find Gary somewhere because he is the one that is talking with the lovely young ladies who take your pledge when you call. Gary, isn't that true?
Yes. You could be talking through this, and it could be going into her here right on television.
Guess who I saw coming in here this morning?
Who?
Porky Chadwick.
You're kidding.
First time I've ever seen him this time of the morning.
This is when he's out normally. Now, these ladies are from South Central Bell. Two of them are from the Kentucky State Home for the Not Quite All There, I'm telling you right now. Strange. What is your name?
Sandy Donahue.
Sandy? Okay, thank you. You hung up on somebody just when I asked your name? Okay, but like, you know our telephone number, so give us a call. I got a few pledges to read. Mr. and Miss Jackie Trent of 5118 Fay Avenue, $5. Frank and Ellie Bird, Madison, Indiana, $24. Mr. and Mrs. Francis B. Whitehouse, Jr., 1301 Abbeywood Road, $120. Jerry, you got some pledges?
I sure do, Gary. And we just had someone walk up to the back door a while ago with a $5 pledge, $5 in cash, that is, in memory of Howard Stinson III.
$10,208?
Yes.
So that's tremendous.
The square dancers are on their way. Look out, fire departments.
I'm Jim Michelle with Convenient Food Marts. We are happy to announce that this year's grand total is $8,000.
$6.91.
All right. $6.91. Can you go ahead and put it in there? Oh, got to open up all the way. $6.91 out of the Taylor brothers here.
I'm John Clark with General Electric, and I'm chairman of the Employee Community Fund, which represents all of the employees at General Electric.
General Electric Employees Community Fund to the Crusade for Children. $60,000.
Salem, Indiana, and Larry Brown's got a few words for us.
This year we have $10,197.92.
All right. It's $10,192.
Fisher Packing Company. This amount that they are giving this year amounts to $32 per employee. That total, and I'll say this one out loud, is $16,000.
We're getting close to $300,000. Look at that, $296,898.
Okay, and we're over here with the St. Matthews Fire Department with Rick Albers and Kent Monahan. Okay, what's the grand total?
Gives us a grand total of $25,500 even.
That is remarkable.
Mutual's here.
We think we'll just give you a figure and then we go home. $19,187.10.
$19,000!
It looks like a bunch of people from Middletown to me.
That's right.
I can tell them a mile away, Jerry.
What's the total?
The grand total this year is $20,004.41.
Oh, my gosh! Fire Department, and Chief, you have a few things to say?
We'd like to give this in memory of Charles Lee, the past chief of South Dixie Fire Department, a total of $16,670.40.
Oh, fabulous. From the South Dixie Fire Department, let's listen to
them. The Archbishop is with us, and this means a very dramatic point in our birth. You don't bring any boots full of money, but...
No,
you bring the word.
We bring the word. That's important. Today's the word to get it out. Evangelization is the word.
Right.
So our grand total this year is $67,700.75.
We've got another group of 30 or 40 volunteer fire department people, scouts, McMahon volunteer fire department, and they got a new record.
And our grand total this year...
Grand total this year...
is $19,000 even.
$19,000 even from the McMahon Volunteer Fire Department. How about that? Pour it in.
We are ready over here. We have got the Okolona Fire Department with a cast of thousands.
$41,500.
Wow. $41,000. Put her in there. We are here with a group from Camp Taylor. This thing gets more incredible as we roll along. It's amazing. As you'll note on the board, we are approaching $900,000. And with Pat Wright, the chief at Camp Taylor.
Our total for this year's 1979 Crusade, $23,739.83.
Fantastic. That's it.
I want you to pay attention to some very important initials. This is Milton Metz and PRP. Stands for one of the great organizations, Pleasure Ridge Park Fire Department. When they come, silence reigns because they come strong, men, women, and children. And we don't know what they're bringing, but they're bringing a lot of good things.
And we have a grand total of $58,356.68.
I have lots of people, as you can easily see here, representing the Fern Creek Volunteer Fire Department.
The grand total was $17,189.86.
Oh, and that's something from Fern Creek Volunteer Fire Department. Over $17,000. Give it, let me get out of the way.
Now the great thing comes forward from
the Clark County Citizens Group.
Right. And we have $48,725.87.
Yay! Great!
This is Mr. George Krause from over in New Albany.
How you doing, Mr. Krause? My pleasure.
Is your daughter standing next to him?
Hi, how are you?
She's been a fan of yours since she was a teenager. Get over there and make her happy, huh?
I can't give you an exact figure because we're still kind of counting money over in New Albany. Still has some money coming in. But I can tell you this. It is in excess of $30,000.
In excess of $30,000. Phyllis, before the show, you remember you wrote something down in the book, and you wrote down your guess and my guess on the end of the show.
I think
we split it about 50-50.
We just about did,
yeah.
Didn't we?
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. You said 200, 1,200,000.
Right.
I said 1,225,000. It comes out 1,217,572.
You know, our joy at this fantastic total is tinged with sorrow today because Jim is retiring. And Jim, you know, we found no way to package love and respect. But knowing your love of silver, we have a little gift for you. And I want to say it will be etched, and this is what it will look like. Wayne, would you hold it for the camera, please?
It's a show.
With our love, Jim.
Too much. Thing I can think to say is I think personally I've gotten more out of it than anybody else has. I mean, it's just been a wonderful experience, and one I'll never forget.
Well, we'll never forget you, Jimmy, and we come to the time when we must say to the community, thank you. Today we'd like to say you are the most generous people in the entire world. Each of you, from those of you who gave a quarter to $10,000, we hope you feel very proud of the total of the Crusade for Children for this 26th year. Those of us who have brought you the Crusade are glad that we could be a part in providing the setting for your generosity so that all of our handicapped children will have a much better life.
God bless America.